Hi there, my name's Derek, and in the next 20 minutes, I'm going to show you how to build a similarity search with AWS AppSync and Amazon Bedrock. If you don't know what a similarity search is, well, this is sometimes called a semantic search. And it's just simply a fancy word for a search that returns items that are close to or like the search string that are used to prompt it. Now, you may be hearing this term more and more in a world where GenAI agents and RAG, or Retrieval Augmented Generation, are all becoming common terms that we are starting to use when we talk about building modern software products. If you haven't heard any of these terms yet, I'll include some links in the introduction and the description of these videos so you can see the topics below. I suggest you watch these first before watching this video. So let's begin by looking at the six steps that you need to perform to create a semantic search with GenAI and RAG. Step one, find the data that we're interested in and send it to an embeddings model. This data can exist in one of many external sources like documents, images, web URLs, and databases, also proprietary data sources. Step two, create the embeddings of this data using an LLM model and store the results in a vector store, which is simply an array of floating point numbers. This step may also include substeps, such as chunking, which is simply splitting up large datasets, like a 100 megabyte PDF, into smaller parts for indexing. Step three, next the user then inputs the prompt to the embeddings model, which again transforms this into an array of floating point numbers. Next is step four, the result is applied as a semantic query to the vector store. Step five, the result of this is then applied along with the original user prompt to a foundation model. Step six, finally, the result is returned to the user who entered the original search term. So as you can see, we need access to large language models or LLMs to create the embeddings for the data and to interpret the user prompt. For this, we can use Amazon Bedrock because it provides API access to a large number of different LLMs. We can then pick and choose which is the best to suit our needs to generate and access the embeddings for our search. However, another aspect we often don't think about is how we are going to orchestrate and control access to the data sources that are being passed around in our backend of our semantic search application. How do we secure the data from the client, and how do we easily orchestrate the queries as they pass through the API layer of the application? Well, this is precisely where AWS AppSync comes in. If you don't know AWS AppSync, it is a managed GraphQL service that enables developers to build, deploy, and manage their GraphQL schemas, resolvers, and data sources. GraphQL is a fantastic solution to use when building agents and RAG, as it allows for the consolidation of data across a number of different data sources, and also provides the ability to control what data is pulled from each data source. Not only that, but it also provides the cache functionality so you can cache queries from each data source and reduce response times back to the user who is calling it. So if we look to see how the same six steps as before would look, but instead of using AWS AppSync to handle the user requests and access the various data sources of the application, we see that steps 1 to 3 are very similar, with the data being transformed into embeddings and loaded into the Postgres database. However, what has changed is the user interacts with AWS AppSync endpoint directly. AWS AppSync then controls how the user connects and also controls calling into the various data sources. It does this by defining resolvers into each data source, and this is where it can cache the queries into these data sources and improve the application. So the last diagram represents also what we're going to build today. We will do it in three steps that I will show you in the upcoming demo. Step one, we will create a Postgres data store and enable the VectorDB feature. We will also upload a CSV file containing Amazon product data. This is the free data source that we have downloaded from Kaggle. Step two, we will next generate embeddings from this data using Amazon Bedrock and store the results in the Postgres vector store we created in step one. Finally, step three, we will deploy an AWS AppSync instance that will connect to the data source and expose some queries. These queries are then invoked by the users to search the vector data store and return the products that are similar to the search term used. Okay, let's dive into the demo. Okay, let's jump into the demo. So here I have Visual Studio Code and a project called SimSearch already checked out. So SimSearch is using the AWS CDK to deploy all of its assets. These assets are called Database Stack, Import Data Stack, and AppSync Middleware Stack. Let's first of all deploy the RDS stack, which is the database stack. What this is doing is simply deploying an instance of Amazon Aurora Postgres. I'll actually speed this one up because it can take some time, and I will connect to this database because what we really want to show here is how to enable vector DBs in Postgres. So into the AWS console, you'll notice the database stack has deployed. We open up a query editor. Now, how we're going to connect to this database once I select it is using Secrets Manager ARN. So this is a secure way to connect to such a database, and the credentials and the URL for this have been outputted by the CDK stack. So I'm copying this from the output of the previously run CDK stack. Once I've copied it, we can switch back over to the AWS console, paste in the Secrets Manager ARN that I've copied, and then finally enter the name of the database, which is this in this case called just called Postgres. I'll then connect to the database, remove what's already there because we don't need any of that, and then input the statement that will enable the vector extension. So here it is, very simple statement to execute. I run the statement and then just check that it has successful. Next, once we finish the RDS stack, we jump into our CDK and we look at the next stack, which is the import data stack. The import data stack is where we pull the CSV product data and we create the embeddings. So let's run this again as a CDK deploy import data stack. This time, while this is running, we may have a look at what it's actually doing. So let's just wait until it starts. As you can see, it uses the outputs of the previous stack, the RDS stack. And then that will go along and start deploying. So let's have a look at it. If we just jump into the import data stack, you'll see it has a Amazon CSV, which contains all the Amazon product data. That's in the assets folder. So let's have a quick look at that. You can see a lot of information about various products you can buy on Amazon. Now this data, as I said, is freely available on Kaggle, so you can use it too. Once we've got the CSV, the next thing we need to do is build an ECS cluster. So we're building an ECS cluster in Fargate to run these various tasks. The first one is generate embeddings. So let's look at the generate embeddings task, which is here. This is a Python task that's running in the container. And as you can see, we're using the Amazon Titan model to generate the embeddings. It needs a bucket URL, which contains the CSV file. And we simply output the results into a new CSV file, which is called embeddings.csv. The next part of this step is to then grab that CSV and then start importing it into our newly created database. You can see here I'm setting up the limits of the task and etc. for ECS. Let's look at the second part of that task, which is the import data step. Here we get our CSV file. We look at each column in the CSV file, and then we insert the data into the database that we created. So we read the embeddings.csv, We grab the information where our database is, and then we perform a number of SQL statements. You'll notice that the embedding.vector column is at the end, and that will include all the embeddings information. Okay. So next, once that's done, we then just make sure we've got the right access and we're right and all the secrets are in the right place. So that task is now run. We've got everything deployed. So let's just check the information is there. So we're doing select count on product info, which is one of the columns in the table. We can see we've got 282 different products imported into Postgres. Next, let's have a check to make sure the embeddings are there. So we're going to then just select product name and the embeddings from the product info table. You can see here, we've got a product name, or the product info, sorry. And then this is all the embeddings representation. See, it's just an array of floating point numbers. So next is the AppSync stack. The AppSync stack is where we deploy AWS AppSync. The first thing we need to do when deploying AppSync is define the schema. So let's look at a typical schema that we're going to use. In schema.graphql, we are reflecting the data store, so product ID, product info, and we also have two queries, get product by ID and get product by similarity search. Let's look at those. The most interesting one is get product by similarity search, which is invoking a Lambda function. The second one is just doing a select from product info where product ID is the product ID displayed. Once we've defined that, we then need to give it a resolver into the various data sources. So for this, we need a data source, which is the Postgres database where all our product info is. And then for the second one, we are defining a Lambda function. So this Lambda function is where we're going to do the similarity search. So let's have a look at it. Again, this is a Python file. And in here, we're defining embeddings. We're defining where the database is. And we're defining a SQL statement. Notice it is doing a like query. So this is where our similarity search is happening. Once we've found enough records, it will return a result. We then finish creating the Lambda function and then set it up as a resolver, so a different data source in AWS AppSync. So now we have two data sources. We have the Lambda data source and we have the Aurora Postgres data source. Once that's deployed, we will then go into the AWS console and have a look and test AWS AppSync. So it's now deploying. It's finished, so let's have a look at it. Switching back to the AWS console. This is the AWS AppSync part of the AWS console. Clicking into similarity search, we can just have a look at the schema, just make sure it's deployed. Here's the schema, it looks exactly like it did in our IDE. And then we have our two queries. Notice the resolvers are set as RDS and Lambda data source. If we look at the query, we can actually run the query here. So we're getting get product by similarity search with batteries, and that's going to return all the product information that is like batteries. And you'll see the product info and the category. So that's it working. Now we need a client. So with AWS AppSync, we can use and generate all of the queries and that we need to run from the GraphQL schema. Because GraphQL, you can introspect the schema. So this is what we're doing. We're building out a very simple UI that calls the AWS AppSync endpoint and gets the result and displays it for the user. And we're doing this in a very simple React app. Here I'm going through all the code that does the calling and displaying of the results. So let's run it and see what it looks like. NPM start runs the application, give us a endpoint that we can just then browse. So here's the application, search for products. Again, I'm going to try battery. I hit search. It'll call AWS AppSync, which will perform the similarity search. And here we are, all of the products that are like battery in the product list that we have. And that's the demo. That is similarity search using AWS AppSync. Pretty easy. And that's it. So what have we done today? We have built a similarity search application that will search Amazon product data and return items that are similar to the search term. And we've done this with AWS AppSync, acting as our facade to the data, and Amazon Bedrock, the facade to the large language models that we needed. What we didn't do is implement any caching in AWS AppSync. We could have also kept a record of search history in something like Amazon DynamoDB, which AWS AppSync could have also used as an additional data source. Both of these additions would enhance the application. So let me know in the comments if you'd like to see another video on how to implement these features. If you like this video, please subscribe to the AWS Developers channel. I've also put in some links in the description to help you should you also want to build a similarity search. So thanks for watching, and I'll hopefully see you next time. Bye.